everyone. Good morning. This is Continental Aspire Soccer, and I'm here with none other than Sergei Baltacha. Just to give you a little bit of information about Sergei, Sergei was the first Soviet Union-based player to come to play in British football, stretching back to 1988. He played over 45 games for the Soviet Union, which obviously Soviet Union collapsed in the 26th of December 1991. We're going to talk about his career. He also won the under 21 World Cup and European Championships, followed by being in the 1988 European Championships, where they sadly lost to Holland, and going on to win four league titles with Dynamo Kiev, including Russian Super Cups, and the 1986 Cup Winners, European Cup Winners Cup with Dynamo Kiev, when they beat Atletico Madrid. Before then, obviously, 2 years later, we actually go on to play in another European Championship final, but more for the Soviet Union, with one of the best Soviet dynasties, and successful teams of the former Soviet Union. So I just want to welcome Sergei. Welcome to the CAS podcast.
Nick, thanks very much. Pleasure.
Sergei, I just wanted to start off today. I wanted to kind of ask, you know, who were you when you were in school? You know what I mean? Just give us a little bit of background, kind of where you're from, a little bit about your family and things like that.
Like, I was born in the city of Mariupol. It's Azov Sea. It's very holiday place for people. Like, during summertime, they come in, they have holiday. It's usually very hot place when, like, maybe during summertime, maybe plus 35, 40, because of Sea of Azov. During winter time, it's not a lot of snow because it's south of that time, like Russian was USSR, it's south. It's Black Sea, like Mariupol, it's one of the part of. It's a lot of time, like when I play football, it's no snow. I never till I not join academy in Kharkov, I never see snow, like real snow, you know what I mean? Not many times, like it's because of time of winter time, it's maybe plus one, maybe kind of this temperature, maybe zero, maybe, but no snow. And all my background, I have mom, dad, they never play football. granddad, grandmom, you know, I was in a happy family. Like, grow up, I remember, like, first, like, memory of flash when I, like, play football again. You know, everything is about football. I don't know where it come from. It's like my granddad was engineer. He's very, how to say, for that time of his very, very intelligent. He was very, like, we have TV, you know, we had TV. It's not many people our neighbors had that time. And I remember it was like, I was born 1958 and 1961. It's like a lot of people when it's like first Russian rockets went in cosmos, you know. It's a lot of, like, our neighbors came to our house to watch, you know, because we had TV, kind of this sense. But my, I have a brother, older brother as well. But like I said, no one play football, and like, I don't know where it's come from. But I remember myself, it's happy childhood, warm outside, very hot outside. And yeah, like, play football all days. It's what about, you know, I created a lot of 10,000 hours, you know, till playing, like, from 9 o'clock morning till 10 o'clock evening, football. And this is like my memory about my, like, Mariupol, my childhood. It's about football and a beautiful space like Mariupol, you know, city where I was born.
Right. Okay. Tell me this, at that time, because obviously when you look at like a lot of sports, the major sports, in terms of influences, what were your family like? Were they supportive, in terms of you obviously pursuing a football career, or Were they what were your parents like in that regard?
Yeah, very supportive. Like without my mom, without them, it's like never what to happen. Because when you know I play football, they support me because a lot of homework, a lot of business you need to do like outside house, you know. But they've been very supportive of my wishes because they knew I was very, very desired. I, you know, had high desire. I like if I need. I remember. Like we had when I was in Karamelka, this is, captain was like, we had at 5 o'clock morning session, but it's like during winter time, it's outside cold. I need to walk maybe, I don't know, half hour or two because we didn't have car. 5 o'clock morning, it's no buses work, nothing work. And we had session because it's during winter time, it's cold outside. Like you cannot do this session in, like outside, it's only inside. And only time available was to have this is school away gym. You know, we had 5 o'clock morning. And, you know, I have desire. I said to mom, look, I will be wake up. I said, no, I'm going. Don't worry about this. You know, I'm going myself. Like, don't worry about me take it over there. You know, I was maybe, I don't know, 10 years old maybe at that time, you know. Yeah. And, you know, yeah. And I went. And I went, and only two of us came, you know, from, 18 boys from that team, you know. I was maybe around, 10, 11, yeah. Like, we had session on, yeah, two only boys came, you know, from all of team, you know. And two of them, myself and another, we managed play in professional level. It's very interesting statistic, you know.
Yeah, that is interesting.
It's about desire. Like this talk with you about desire, it's what about, you know. I wanted and I went, it's dark, I remember, you know, you scared to walk over there, but I wanted. Kind of this is sense. And they support me all over, you know, through my grandparents, my parents, my brother, it's, you know, it's what about. Like without them, it's never would happen. Never would happen. And even when it's, Academy invite me to go to Kharkov because it's 12 hours by train. It's like big decision, and you know they spotted me when I play for local team Mariupol. You know where it's like my first coach Valeriy Borisovich Sidorov, who is it's very popular team was in Mariupol at that time when I was 10, 11. I read about them like a lot through newspaper because they won because we had in. Like in USSR that time competition, letterball. It's national competition. Because we had school holiday break from end of the May and June, July, August, 3 months holiday in Russian. Like used to be, I don't know what about now. And all this is 3 months, it was competition letterball. If you started from your, I don't know, village or whatever you live in, you know, small one, you know, and you, like if you in first, step, next one, and you in national, you know.
Wow.
And play so in Moscow.
So the whole Soviet system was very, very strict because obviously it was communism still. It was communism. So, and obviously to young people that don't, our parents don't understand, communism is a very harsh way, but there's also, so during this time then, where was kind of did you kind of see like for example ice hockey, because I know that's probably one of the national sport in Russia, and I know in the Ukraine certain parts of the Ukraine ice hockey is a real rivalry sport that most kids choose to do, but obviously you're in Mariupol, so it's more football weather, isn't it? it's more football related.
Yeah, but still ice hockey was. Like you said, Nick, already, like it was one of the priority sports in USSR that time. Football, ice hockey, skiing, you know, all this is ice because it's like maybe in my area where I used to live in Mariupol, it's no snow, but rest of like USSR, it's snow a lot, you know. And when I moved to, like even in Mariupol, where it's not a lot of snow, but during winter time we play ice hockey, but not real, like without skiing, you know, because we didn't have ice. We, you know, we play with sticks, you know what I mean? play ice hockey, you know, kind of the practice as well. But real ice hockey, I started to learn about when I moved to academy, because we have during winter time, we have ice skiing like once a day, maybe because it's winter and like you cannot go on outside. We didn't know how at that time it was no astroturfs, you know, like all activity, football training was inside door. And one day a week we have like it's like physical preparation, ice hockey or ice skiing. It's very, very good, you know, kind of this is like psychological, physical drill for young players, you know what I mean? And when I moved to academy, I learned a lot about this, you know, because I did not, in my time when I was anymore, I never played ice hockey real, you know what I mean? And never had ice skiing as well. But this is what it's about. This is like that time your society's communism, it's like, was very well organized. What is important, I think, you know, like maybe not many people like understand and remember even, like new generations, right. they don't remember this is country. USSR, what's that? When, like sometimes I'm talking about young players or young kids, you know, they ask me, Sergei, where you come from? I said, oh, okay, look, this is USSR used to be country. They, okay, what country? I said, look, it's now it's like 15 countries, used to be one country. They, oh, I didn't know. I said, yeah, it was huge country. Ways everything in that country was for free. Sport was for free. All sports, arenas, what? Like you never pay money. You know, I think this was the duty. Wow. Academy, where I went to academy, like it's government, it's under government. It's like government, a lot of put money, invest. It's system. It was system, you know. It's like, propaganda.
So you would say that was actually a positive side to the effects communism very positive. Had on sport?
Yeah.
It's like they invest a lot of
facility, sport, you know, like all sports, all this facility for free. Look, I remember in Mariupol we had pitches, whatever, you never pay money, like volleyball, basketball, like facility, you never pay anything. People invited, coaching you over there without, it's government paying everything, you know. Children, we had opportunity because they knew, it's why it was very strict, you know, it's no really big problem, you going and walking streets, it's no criminal, it's like all people work, you know, it was not unemployment, you know, it's different systems than, it's like positive things, you know, kind of this thing. But what's like most important, where is my point? It was important for some opportunity for like me, you know, young people who wanted maybe to think about achieve something in sport, like myself, you know. I play, but I never pay any penny, you know what I mean? Kind of this is things. It's very positive. And they have structure, they have competition. From this competition, they open up 12 full-time academies with people like myself. If I came from another regional, I used to live over there. You know, I used to live with...
So what was the distance? Sorry, Sergei, what was the distance from Mariupol to Kharkiv? What was the...
To Kharkiv. It's 12 hours by train.
Wow.
12 hours. Or maybe
far.
Flying... Okay. Yeah, it's far. It's or maybe it's bigger distance than maybe going from Southampton to Inverness. It's longer.
Right. That's quite far. Yeah.
It's like you need to fly one and a half hour kind of distance.
Okay.
Like USSR used to be a huge country used to be.
It is. It's massive.
And this is where. You know, it's like all this is 12 academies, like they four used to be open in Ukraine. It's like one of them Kiev, one of them Kharkiv, where I was. West was Lugansk, and one of them Lviv. Lviv, it's like west.
Yep.
It's like,
I know what
this is
for.
Yeah. And all of them run by professional people, ex-professional. the system, but you know, I was lucky because I went to academy. They invite me after, because I play locally in Mariupol for this is like football team Karamelka, where is Valery Borisovich. He spotted me, like, interesting. I said to you about leather ball, you know, competition, because it's where he spotted me. I like someday I play in my you know, street football, and some of my friends said, look, Sergei, like during summertime, he said, I was that time maybe around maybe 10, 11 years old, you know, and he said, look, Sergei, and like next to us, it's a stadium where he said, it will be like competition, you know, tomorrow, like come up to us and play game, you know what I mean, for my team. You know, like I had a lot of friends, kind of this. But this is like everything. It's coaches, they organize, kind of this. You know, I did not know this is all rules. I wanted to play this. I came, you know, 9 o'clock morning, that pitch is where it's organized by government people coming like from local council, you know what I mean, kind of this. Is like the coach is supposed to provide names, boom, 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 you know, like official all with names, with certificate should be, you know. But for some reason, they miss one, two players. And this is boy asked me, look, Sergei, could you play for us? But it's illegal, of course, you know what I mean? Play for us. I said, yeah, we'll play. You know, but they're like, they may be 11, 10, like 11, 12 years old. I was 10 only. I maybe 1 year young or even 2 years younger, you know. But I don't care. I play a game. Next hour, sitting watching, another my friend came. Sergei, would you like to play for us? I said, yeah, of course I will. I play maybe next hour for another team. Nick, for another team, you know?
Right.
I'm happy. I finish sitting again watching the next one, like maybe 2 hours time. Another, but it's like all day games, you know what I mean? Another friend came and said, Sergei, would you play for our team? I said, of course I can. I play for third team. And that time, this is organizers, they spot me. I play for third team, you know what I mean? I say, this is guy came like from council, like main referee or like official, you know. He said, hey, young boy, come here. What is your name? And I said, Sergei Baltacha. Why are you playing for three teams? I said, I don't know. They asking. He said, look, you can't, because you're only supposed to be play for one team.
And right.
I said, look, I don't know. You know, he said, look, you disqualify. Right. You cannot play now. You
right.
cannot play now. And I started crying. I remember I sitting on bench, you know, people like playing, and I sitting crying. And some man, maybe that time Valeriy was maybe, I don't know, like 30 years old, maybe around plus minus 27. Maybe.
Right.
Some, you know, gentleman came to me and said, why are you crying?
So when you went to medalist, just so people are aware of this, it's called FC Medalist Kharkiv. Now, a lot of people that don't know this, that was actually the same academy. Andrei Kanchelskis went there.
Many other
great Soviet players. Bissonov.
Yeah, Vladimir Bissonov, who played with me for national team, for Dynamo Kiev, he played for national. It's like, from my generation, when I was in academy, five players, we came from that academy, five. And we played for national team. We won World Cup under 20, five of us. We won under 21, five of us. Five of us, we came in Dynamo Kiev, five of us. And three of us, we played for national team, senior.
You know the one of the questions that I have, that because I think, you know, in the world we live in today, Sergei, people talk about philosophy, they talk about football principles and how they like to play football, right? When you looked at the academy in Kharkiv, what was the philosophy? What was like a typical day, and how would you summarize like the principles of the Soviet Union footballing structure?
Yeah, it was a very well organized structure. Because, like I said, I was lucky to go in Kharkiv Academy because they invite me. Reason why? Because it's Nikolai Mikhailovich Koltsov, who was my coach in Kharkiv. He is ex Dynamo Kiev player. He is who won first national with Dynamo Kiev, and he played with Valery Lobanovskyi in same team.
Right.
You know, it's
who's going to be your future manager? Like, yeah.
Exactly. You know, and philosophy of that, because it's like to related philosophy of that academy, related who is running this academy. You know what I mean? And Koltsov Nikolai Mikhailovich, he was head of coaching in my academy. You know what I mean? And okay. His philosophy was like Dynamo Kiev philosophy, no, Lobanovskyi philosophy. It's why Weiss was lucky to have over the education and move to Dynamo Kiev. And this is was like came in simple, like it's like I continue my development. You know what I mean? I was lucky, you know?
Right.
But this is like philosophy about repetition, 10,000 hours, you know? It's like every day repetition, discipline. All this is boys who've been in this is academies. They have desire, they have good personality, they want to be professional players, they sacrifice life, you know. It's because, like I said, you...
Sergei, can I just ask you, what age were you when you went to the academy? How old were you at the time?
I was just 14 years, you know. I like went in February, when 17 February, I had my birthday. It's winter time, I remember, cold. And I had like my friends from my school where I was in Mariupol. They had like, and they knew I will be leaving, you know, next couple of days. They have big party like in school, you know, to say me like good luck, you know what I mean? And right, some friends, and give me some friends that look, says, you leaving? Because they knew I'm good player that time, you know, in like Mariupol, Karamelka. That time I was voted already best center forward in Ukraine. That's why I was invited to this academy, you know, because a year before I was voted in national competition this leisure, I played center forward, you know, that time. And
okay, so you were a striker before you went?
Yes, yeah, I was striker. Okay. It's where it's like philosophy about, players playing in every position. It's Lobanovskyi philosophy, you know, and Koltsov as well, you know what I mean? It's like player who is like playing Dynamo Kiev, like all of us, we could to play in every position. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Kind of this is sense. It's one of the first. But when I came, it's like I said to you, first one is like competition. When I came over, there was best center forward in Ukraine. But I came in academy, like we before every session, we had like standing up in your height, yeah?
Right.
I was just 14, and I was last. I was last one, smallest. You know, like tall, like everyone taller than me. Like as I said, you know, I was best one, and I did not play maybe first couple months in the team. Like we did not have a lot of games, but still maybe one per 3 months, like during winter time, where I never played because on my position played center forward. Player who is early developer, his name Alexander, you know.
Okay.
And it was from first day I had competition, you know. And it's what is like from first day I started thinking how deal with this. It's what about, you know. It's mentality, right. You know. It's mentality. From first day I said, look, I need to do something. Because I know, I just what he is big, he is early developer, he's very fast, he's already saved. At 14 years he already saved. You know, it's like it's show puppet, you know what I mean?
Right.
He's he was not intelligent player. He was just physical, fast, and that's it, you know. One feet, he did not have left foot. You know, it's like, I'm as player, I'm starting to, you know, to see ways, weaker links of him, you know, how improve myself. And I started work, you know. It's interesting. Like from coaching points, as coaches, you know what I mean? It's what it's about, you know, as coach. But it took me a couple days to see what his strengths, what his weakness. And I started work from first day. From that day, when I came in academy, I never had a day off, Nick. Never, ever. No one day off.
How long was that? You went to medalist Kharkiv Academy, and that was was that 1972?
It was 1972. Yeah, and I finished that academy.
And yeah. how long were you in the academy?
Four years.
Okay, so years, when yeah. you till you were 18.
I graduated when I was 18. You know, I could to graduate at 17, like okay. 1 year before. But we had option if you would like to stay, because what was at the time in USSR, you need to go to army. When you're 18, if you're not in university or you know in high education, if you're not study,
yeah,
you must to go in army. If you okay. in university, you have like if you have in college, no college, university, like 4 years, you like 4 years study, and after like university, you go into army for 1 year only. You know, but from 18 years, if I like 18, I supposed to go into army, and when I was in academy, it's like we had option for every player, or you they said, look guys, you can't stay for one more year. Till 18, you know, and I thought, look, it's good. Like it's not any like everyone took it. This is option, but I took it because it's 1 year for me development. You know, again to have session, kind of this is since you know, kind of this is. I said, and I decided I stay longer. And you know, like from first day, like I said, it's like I understand it's hard working. I was like mentality hard working. You know, it's mentality, but I realized. It's different level now, you know, for me. It's why I'm left Mariupol, because I could to play over there longer. But I knew when I was 12, 14, 13, if I would like to achieve something in football, I need to go. To go somewhere where is more competition for me, where is better players, where is I can't to achieve what I want, you know what I mean? And I 14, you know, at 14, I move over there and I'm started to improve myself.
What about like the in terms of all the coaching and the principles that were being in the philosophy when you went to Medalist Kharkiv Academy, what kind of hit you the most from leaving Mariupol to going into an organized structure where you're not playing for three teams anymore?
You're playing for
one of the best academies in the USSR, and obviously the population of Ukraine is very large. It's not a small country. So
not small.
In terms of the players that were there, were they players before they came where they were being viewed as possible for future Soviet that would play for the Soviet Union?
Yes, yeah. This is all boys been selected. It's only okay. it's like myself from people from all Ukraine. Like it's like we never like we did not have because it was in Ukraine, and like we did not have like anyone because like Kazakhstan or because a lot of republic in that time was in USSR, you know. But we had all players like we call no local but Ukraine only, you know. But they like away like myself, you know. I was Mariupol ways. Yeah. Long way, you know, a lot of us been like this, you know, boys from another city, from West Ukraine, a lot of, you know,
right.
We had only maybe couple local boys who from Kharkiv, you know, rest of they like away, and we stay till maybe like school holiday break, you know, and we went for like at home for a couple days only and come back again, you know, kind of this. But our timetable was like this, Nick, you know, from first day, and I love it. Like, I think in my life, it was one of the best decisions in my life, you know, to write decision, you know, because without right. this decision to go into this academy, I never would achieve what I achieved, you know, in football.
Right.
You know what I mean?
So you believe that Valeriy Lobanovskyi, he really developed those core principles. And did he kind of help you to shape how you thought about football? And how has that changed?
Yes, of course. But like first one, like this is about Kharkiv, you know, Kharkiv. When I make decision, 14 years old boys, to leave house, leave family, and going, like you don't know where, you know what I mean? What is expect, you know, young boy, you know, like I now look back and thinking, I'm watching now 14 years boys and thinking, what the hell? I was 14, you know, and I already knew what I wanted, you know what I mean? And I, right. it's not mom, no mom, no dad, no my granddad make decision. It's me. You know, I said, no, guys, I'm going. I said, look, if you want, you go. Says, you know, no one pushed me. No one said, no, whatever. You know, I said, no, I want. And when you come, like when I came over there, it's what is, I talk in points, Nick. It's structure was, it's like you living over there. You have school, you have educational, you have food, you have people who train you. You only need to find time to relax, sleep, wake up, you know, you sleep. Like our timetable was, Nick, you 7 o'clock wake up morning. You have 1 hour for your like technical work or physical, like it's another word. It was 1 hour for everyone because it's not only was football over there. It's like 420 kids was over there. From youngest was like myself was, I think you could to go over the 13 years old, you know, from 13 to 18. Mm. It was athletics, you know, athletics, cycling, football, and gymnastics.
Wow.
Four sports, yeah, Olympic sports. And in 98 Olympic Games, you know, in Moscow, remember, like where I was playing, like bronze medal.
Mm.
I think 70% of national team USSR was based from this is academy people, all sports. Like football was as well, like in football, like if you're talking about football, like myself, I was a graduate like from academy, and 3-4 more boys been graduate from academy. You know, like Olympic team, 1980 was like Russian football team was 40% of players who graduate from academy. It's quite,
that's
a quite good outcome. Wow. Yeah, it's quite good. It's the reason why good one, you know, because of system work, you know. Like I said, I came over there, you not need, your parents not need to look after you, like taking time off from work, bringing to your like training ground, bringing back.
Right.
No, you base over there, you 7 o'clock wake up, you have hour for training for by yourself. You're going outside, even winter time, like minus 20, snow. You're doing exercise, you know, it's up to you, you know. But I'm from first day because we used to live in same room. 18 boys, team, you know, when I came. We sleep. And when I wake up 7 o'clock, I could to see Alexander who play on my place, yeah?
Center right, four. Okay.
He's sleeping over there. And he was lazy, I couldn't believe. He's never ever had kind of this session. He sleep, and I wake up, I look, it's really drive me, you know, like I'm, like it was competition. I wake up, he's sleeping. I went outside and I like play technical, whatever. I like cross country used to do, whatever I needed to do. I was motivated, you know, because I know I'm every day doing more than him. And I knew that time, someday I will be taking over him. And this is what happened.
Yeah.
1 month's time, I started playing.
So you you would say at 14, you knew when you looked at this guy, you were like, I'm going to overtake, this guy is not going to, he's not going to be a professional. You already had the mentality that you were going to make it.
Yeah, competitiveness. Yeah, I don't know if he make it or not. I don't know. I wanted only one thing that time, you know, to be better than him, because he took my position. He's
right.
Played center forward. You know, he's played center forward in team where in academy. You know, I wanted to become better than him. He was physically more. It's why I'm started run more cross country. Why I'm started to invade more physical plyometric exercise, skipping, you know, skipping roll to improve my legs, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Be stronger, much quicker, you know, and it took me maybe months. I became stronger and I like started grow up, you know, kind of this is things, you know, it's after when I was like in like university, started study what is like physical, like educational, you know, theory, I started to understand, you know, I done right things, you know, kind of this is things. But this is what I was born competitor, is what about, you know. And so, you know,
so when you look at like the competitiveness, and you look at obviously as an academy, they were doing a mixture of sports. But the way that, so if you look at like the people that really shaped you from 14 to 18, what would you say? I mean, in terms of, you know, the fact that you see a guy like Valeriy Lobanovskyi, and he was obviously serving in the academy at that time. Had he, so he was 30 and he had just finished playing. He had had a playing career.
No. Кольцов Николай Михайлович Кольцов. He's like Лобановский из Динамо Киев.
Okay, so when he, so whenever, so
Кольцов Николай Михайлович.
Okay, so in terms of their kind of vision and their philosophy. So obviously you obviously transition, and then what actually happens? So once you finish the academy, what's kind of the next transition for you? So how did Dynamo Kiev come about? What happened there?
Yeah. It's very interesting question, Nick. You know, it's like from 14 years old, I was under like supervision or coach like Nikolai Mikhailovich Koltsov. It's my first, like, my second coach, you know, consider my first one in Mariupol. He's ex-professional player. He played for Dynamo Kiev. He was, you know, mates of Lobanovskyi, you know, they played together, you know. And he was lead coach in this academy. And all philosophy, it was similar to Dynamo Kiev, similar, because he used to play, you know, and he played with Lobanovskyi a long time, you know. And his philosophy was exactly the same, you know, 4 years. It's like our timetable for every day. It was like you 7 o'clock wake up, you have 1 hour individual work. It's like you have, it's up to you, technical, physical, whatever you want. You know, after you come back, it's 8 o'clock, you have shower, like prepare, half past eight, you have breakfast. 9 o'clock, started school, because it's same building. You have 2 lessons in school. After you have break, and you have session. 1 hour, 1.5 hour session, because speech next to us. 1.5 first session. After you come back, you have lunch. After lunch, you have another 3 sessions in school, because it's same building. After you come back from 3, this is lessons, you have second session, 1 more hour. After second session, you come back, you have some food, you know, a little bit, some, you know, some sandwich, kind of this things. And you go into for some rest, you have some rest, and you have going in classroom for 2 hours, you have homework for next day. During this is, you know, like homework time, you have dinner. You finish this is around 9 o'clock all together, evening, and you have 1 hour free time, you know, whatever you want to do, you know. 10 o'clock you're going to bed.
Okay.
And next morning same again. It's discipline, but most important what I said, twice a day session, 3 times a day session, you know, like with your morning, you know. It's why I'm saying it's like systematically. It's why is Russian that time USSR philosophy was good, because like principle of development, it's repetition. It's before 18 years old, you need to have 10,000 hours. What is 10,000 hours give to player? It doesn't matter. Football, tennis, whatever, it's sport. It's same principles, Nick, you know. It's 10,000 hours give your brain automatical. You're doing everything automatically.
I think it's quite interesting, because I think that when I think of like the Soviet Union, and I think about, you look at like their hockey team in the 80s, you look at how successful they were in the 60s and the 70s, and you look at they're people that they've always been under a form of oppression. And so the culture, if you look at the cultural aspect, would you say kind of communism really made the sports aspect of the Soviet Union very strong, because it was all well organized and things like that?
Yeah, I think this is what it's about. This is politically, it was for government, because they knew they're going outside this country. You know, they need to show why communism is better than capitalism. You know what I mean? It's kind of right. This is political. It's political, you know, issue. You know what I mean? It's for. Right. It's like kind of like political wars to win, you know, because it's why it was very big competitive, like America against Russian ice hockey, you know what I mean?
Right, yeah.
Was a rivalry, you know, Nick, was right. Rivalry, you know, and
absolutely.
And, like USSR, like government want to show all world, like USSR good at sport.
Right.
You know what I mean? And it was all coaches very well educated, ex-professional, right. You know, like I remember all this is my like football career on top, like with Lobanovskyi when I was. It's all education, coaches, top class coaches, children coaches, top class. You know, equipment, like everything is top class. Facility, competition, pitches, referees. You know, it's government, communism. They know what needed. You know what I mean? To achieve this, you know, because scientific very well. Like when I came in Dynamo Kiev, it was in 1976. With that time, we had so much scientific behind us, you know what I mean? Like when I came in Ipswich and play in England, even like 20 years after, like Dynamo Kiev was 20 years, like affront everyone. Or Lobanovskyi. Like it's not every team in Russia used to be, you know, it's like Lobanovskyi. He was ahead of 20 years, everyone. You know what I mean?
Wow.
His philosophy.
So that's kind of what made you think, you know what I mean? You're going to learn under the right coach, and you're going to learn under a visionary, really a Soviet Union visionary, you know, or as people like to call a lot of managers now, they call Pep Guardiola the philosopher. So he was really the philosopher of Soviet Union football. It's funny because I read Andrei Kanchelskis's book Russian Winters, and he actually spoke about Valeriy Lobanovskyi. You know what I mean? It's one of his biggest inspirations. It's been a really great conversation today. I've really enjoyed it. Learned a lot. learned a lot, and I hope anybody else that has any comments and any questions, obviously we'll take questions. Sergei will actually answer any questions that we'll actually forward on to him, but you can actually message us, leave all your comments in the section below, and you can follow us on www.continentalaspiresoccer.com, or you can see us on social media across Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter for any questions you may have, and I'm sure we can get Sergei to actually answer those. And obviously you've learned a lot on here today. But Sergei, just want to thank you for your time to come and speak with us. Like I say, any information that people have, I'm sure you'll definitely be able to answer.
Nick, thanks very much. It was a pleasure and privilege.
Sergei will actually be doing some clinics and stuff at Continental Aspire Soccer. So it'd be a good opportunity for you to come down and really learn from a very successful player, very good coach. So thank you very much, and have a great day.